planning some travel abroad. Hi, wow, a lot of people stayed. Great, thank you.
I'll start by just asking you, what made you want to make this film, particularly?
What made me want to make this film? I was paying attention. A couple years ago. 3 years ago, I mean, I was thinking about it, you know, 3-4 years ago, even making my last film, which was called Incident in New Baghdad. And that film was really made possible by someone who's in prison right now for 35 years named Chelsea Manning. And he had released some video from Iraq, among a lot of documents, but the video was really captured everyone's attention of this American helicopter attack in Baghdad. And I fashioned a short film around that, which was about a soldier on the ground. But of course, I was thinking at the time, like, wow, you know, this information war about over information is going on, where some people are allowed to release information and other people aren't, and the punishments were crazy. And then I read about Tom Drake's piece around a piece by Jane Mayer about Tom Drake around that same time. So after I finished Incident in New Baghdad, I started to kind of start doing some research for this film, and I grew into Silenced. So
I'm gonna open it up because we got a big house here. Let's right there.
Can you give us a little bit of an update on what's happening with the three whistleblowers?
The question is, can you give an update on what's happening with the three whistleblowers?
Yeah. They wanted to be here. Unfortunately, they had Tom and Jesselyn had a prior engagement, but John is still in prison. He's been very outspoken from prison, which is not increasing his chances of getting out early on parole, unfortunately. So I don't think he's due to come out till next year. There is a website for him if you're interested, defendjohnk.com, which gives you updates. And his Fire Dog Lake, the website, has been publishing these letters that he's been writing from prison. Tom still works at the Apple Store. 3-4 days a week, and does a lot of travel, speaking out about government transparency and the NSA and all the overreach going on. And Jesselyn is, you know, still fighting her fight to defend whistleblowers any way she can. Her latest client is Edward Snowden.
What do you think the reception will be in the U.S. for this documentary?
Yes. Well, we premiered it at Tribeca 2 weeks ago, and it was a really great reception. But there was, you know, I mean, some of the questions from the audience, I think, were, I wouldn't call them hostile, but, you know, there were definitely some hackles up, I think. You know, there's one of the things this film does, I hope, is peel away the partisan veneer a little bit. What we're talking about here are the structures of power. Mm-hmm. And the structures of power are consistent across different parties in governments. Mm-hmm. And that has certainly been true in this area of national security, where the Bush administration policies have just been pretty much seamless right into the Obama administration's policies. And particularly in this area of, you know, civil rights, a lot of people are saying Obama's been worse, mm-hmm. and certainly has presided over this greatest use of the Espionage Act ever. I mean, they've set a record at this point. In fact, while I was making the movie, the number kept going up. It says 6 in the movie. I believe it's up to 8 now. And, you know, I mean, I expect it might even be higher by the time we go into general release.
Back here.
Yeah, can you tell us about the decision to use reenactments and why that works in this particular film?
The question was about your decision to use reenactments and why it works in this particular film.
Yeah, I hope it works. I decided very early on I wanted to do that. I went down, when the first time I met Jesselyn and Tom, we just sat down and talked for like 4 hours at Jesselyn's offices, and I was just hearing these stories, and I just thought they were so incredibly dramatic. And I come from a fiction film making background, and I thought there was a way that I could somehow visualize that, take us into that dark world. And I thought there wasn't a way to do it with, like, still pictures and sort of archival material in the same way, I kind of wanted it to have this sort of otherworldly, like, heart of darkness almost feeling, like we're going into this weird space. And it's kind of like mirrors the characters' journeys, hopefully, that you know, they basically all tell the same story in a way. I signed up for one thing, and then I got there, and it was like, wait, this is just not at all what I expected. And so I wanted it to have that kind of almost surreal feeling. And they all kind of describe it that way at various points as surreal or Kafka-esque or, you know. So that was kind of the inspiration for that.
We have time for a couple more. Let's do back here.
Can you tell us what's happening with legal fees? Is anyone trying to raise money to cover them? Are they getting written off, or what's happening?
The question is, what is happening with the legal fees?
The legal fees, yeah. I'm not sure about Tom's. I mean, I know if you go to that Defend John Kay website, and also, I mean, we're just building a website for the film, but silencefilm.com, but if you go to that, that'll also be a place to get updates and stuff eventually. I'm very active on Facebook too, so find me on Facebook or find the film on Facebook. But yeah, I know there, John's family is still actively trying to raise money. You know, I don't really know exactly if the lawyers are going to give him some sort of break or not.
So one more, I'm going to go right here. Yeah. Question is, why do you think more Americans aren't outraged at what's happening to their country?
The million-dollar question. I think Americans might be the most heavily propagandized populace in the world. I mean, I don't know about North Korea, but you know, it's so embedded, and that's what I was trying to get at. I mean, I don't want to just sit here and bash the media. I mean, I tried to be even-handed in this movie. Like, you know, Tom Drake is kind of saved by the media in a way. But you could see what happened to John Kiriakou, and there's a lot of sort of embedding, and it's just there's a lot of, I think, quid pro quo, and a lot of not wanting to mess with your sources and national security. So and so the information that Americans are getting is probably not very good if they're just turning on, you know, the TV, which is how most people get their news. You know, obviously, it's something that disturbs me. It's why I make movies about this, that hopefully I can do more than preach to the converted. I do see something interesting happening over these issues of surveillance, particularly where the right and the left are both kind of struck by the scope of this and for different reasons maybe upset about it. Hopefully there's greater awareness, and I think the Snowden revelations had a big part in that.
Okay, well, I want to thank James for coming.
I'd stay longer, but they're throwing us out for the next week.